गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सी अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल पिक्चर ऑन योर स्क्रीन. सी द वाटर इज देयर, पाम ट्रीज आई थिंक, देन द बोट इज देयर एंड टू चिल्ड्रन आर सिटिंग एंड दे आर एंजॉइंग. सी अ लॉट ऑफ ग्रीनरी इज देयर, कोकोनट ट्री इज देयर. सी सी सो ब्यूटीफुल. So today we are going to read a story that is very much related to these boats, water, coconut trees and children. So today we are going to start a story, or you can say the chapter of your reader, and that is your chapter number 2. So let us see the name. What is the name of the chapter? And the name of the chapter is Battling Boats. Battling Boats. Boats you know very well, and battle you have also heard, a fight you can say. So similarly, the battling boats, the boats that are struggling to win, they are in the competition, or you can say boat race is there, only then the competition is there, and they struggle. Many people are there when the boat race is there, and they try their best to win. They do what they can do, means they try very much hard so that they can win. So the same story we are going to read today, and you must have your books and you listen. See, I think you can read now from the book. Boat races are a popular event in Kerala, especially during the harvest festival of Onam. We know very well that Onam is the festival of Kerala, and it is the harvest festival of Kerala, and it is celebrated there. In this story by Mukta Munjal, Kuttan, a young boy, is eager to participate in the race, but he discovers a dark secret the night before the race. So the name of the writer you can say, that is Mukta Munjal, and Kuttan is a young boy there. The name of the boy is Kuttan, and he is very much eager to participate in the race, means he wanted to participate in the race. And he discovers, means find out, a dark secret the night before the race. Read on to find out what the boy does and what happens during the race. See what was done by the boy and what happened when the race was there. Okay, so we are going to start the chapter. It was a warm-up activity. So you must have seen such type of races on the television, because we are living in north areas, and in north areas such type of races are not there. It is especially in Kerala. Some may have visited and some might have seen. So let us see. That's the last fish sold, come on. Sukarman left, let us go, said Kuttan, picking up his half empty basket. Means two boys are there and they are talking to each other, and the one boy is Kuttan and the other is Sukumaran. So they both are there, they are in the market you can see, and they are selling the fish, because it is told in the first line, that's the last fish sold. Come on Sukumaran, let's go, said Kuttan, picking up his half empty basket. But there are a dozen coconuts left, protested Sukumaran. Means one boy is selling fish and the other boy is selling coconuts. His coconuts were left more, therefore he was not ready to go. Then, I don't care, replied Kuttan. To Today I won't sit here till the last coconut is sold. I'm too excited. So the boy was not ready. The boy is Kuttan. He is not ready to sit for the last coconut to be sold, because it may take a long time, because many were left, not one or two, dozen were left. So it may take a long time. Therefore, he was not ready to sit there. Sukumari looked at his friend a little enviously. How lucky you are to be rowing in the boat race tomorrow. Imagine you will be famous, the youngest. And dash is written there, means he was praising Kuttan, because Kuttan was going to participate in the boat race that was going to be held tomorrow. And he was telling him that you are very lucky. Kuttan was already stepping into his dugout canoe, which was strung together with coir ropes. The two boys paddled away from the marketplace, where the fisherwoman in gaily colored saris balanced fish baskets on their head as they shouted out the prices of dried and freshwater fish, coconuts and sea fish. Generally, we have seen on TV that the markets are there, and the ladies especially, they have baskets on their heads and they sell the fishes and the fish of freshwater also, and sea fish are also there, means different type of fish are there, then coconut is there. So the ladies are selling all these things, and Kuttan, the boy, he was already stepping into his dugout canoe. Dugout canoe means a small narrow boat made by cutting out the inside a tree trunk. See the boy sitting there. It is a tree trunk, and they have dug it and made a boat, and they both are sitting here in this. So Kuttan has gone to the boat and he has taken his seat, and the boat was there with the coir ropes. It was tied with that. Now the two boys paddled away from the marketplace. Paddled away means they were gone away from there. And where the fisherwoman in gaily colored saris, they were balanced fish basket on their heads, and they were shouting out of the price of dried and fresh water fish. The fish were dry also, and they were of fresh water also. They were coconuts also and sea fish also. The ladies, they were crying and they were speaking the prices of these things so that they may sell them. Barefoot children were frolicking on the swings tied between tall swaying palms. Barefooted means the children, those who have not worn the slippers in their feet. They were enjoying the swings. Backwater was so crowded today, exclaimed Sukumaran. Everybody come for the races. Backwater means the area that was very much near the sea, and that was very much crowded, means many people were there, and they were, everyone come for the races. They have come to do the practice so that they might win the race. Means people were doing a lot of practice so that they can win. So the same thing was also there. So tomorrow we shall continue the reading of the chapter. Okay. You read this chapter, start reading page number 1, and you underline the words that you find difficult. Write their meanings in your notebook, and then we shall continue the reading tomorrow also. and you can describe this picture also. It's your extra work that you describe the picture and write at least 10 sentences in your revision notebook. So it's bye for today. Bye, students.